top 10 in her career. That's 21 events.
Let's go, girls.
5 wins on the World Tour for Kleinman Ross. 16 wins overall, if you include the AVP. They're a force to be reckoned with, but Russia serves so, so well. We've seen them already serve Germany off the court earlier on, but not the USA. April Ross turns one back. This is going to be a very interesting matchup, to say the least. They've already met twice before, both times in 2018, actually, and both times the USA won those matchups. But the pandemic, well, it's been kind for Kleinman Ross because they've come out firing, but also for Russia, nobody is the call. Russia absolutely fired up here. They want this one, don't they? You just feel that Russia have improved a lot throughout this 18-month quiet period due to COVID-19. 2/5 since then. Obviously, the USA won in Doha. But Kleinman, scooped by Kolomina, twice by Svetlana Kolomina. My words, that's extraordinary play. And if you didn't think Russia meant business before this game, you certainly do now, showing no signs of nerves. And trying to keep their calm. Matvogas over. Trying to focus fully on the serve. Climbing the target straight down the line. Coming on a slight angle. And turning that ball on a slight angle as well. What a swing that one is. The focus here is so, so high from both teams. Kleinman, who played for Navarra, Moco, and prior club in Brazil. Also played for the USA national team. Wasn't completely new to beach, did play as a junior. Played a little bit of AVP as well. Still an impressive return from her international beach volleyballing career. Lots of hard work done with Jen Kessie, former partner of April Ross. Won the World Championships together, along with the guidance of Jeff Conover, led them through London. Kessie, the coach of Kleinman Ross for some time before moving with her family. Just happened that Angie Akers was just finishing up with her post with the Netherlands and moved back to the USA. April Ross, full stretch with the left arm and the cut shot as well. This is a great start to the game. Russia have played some brilliant beach volleyball, but so have the USA. High line seen from Ross. Releases late. Has great vision to palm it away. Very well done from April Ross. Now she has a chance to serve away. Rocket. What a serve. Always talking, communicating. Ross is on high off the hands. Another point for the USA. Going to Olympics number 3. What a career Ross has had. Kleinman Ross won all 3 of the AVPs in 2020. Quite international year, but the AVP actually got some great events on the coastline of California. We've seen that from Kolomina before. She comes in, shows the line with her arm swing, and then just goes back angle. some smiles from her, which shows that Russia are enjoying this one. It was a knuckle to the sideline. Very good. Long from Maklogazova. They've won four times together. Twice in senior beach volleyball, a Napa one start in 2018. But they grew through that in 2019, won that four-star in Espino. They beat Sarah Sponsel and Kelly Clays in that final. Rebecca, Anna Patricia taking the third. Agatha and Duda fourth that week, so a very good draw. Yes, a few teams missing, but that was really a step up for them to win a four-star event. On two, Maklogazova beats penetrating Alex Kleinman into the net. The athleticism on show is scary. Russia still trail by two, though. Serve to the inside hand to track that one and turn it. Great effort. Ross serves straight. A look and a little chip back on the cut shot. This is, well, it's giving us everything we ever wanted. April Ross. Been a breeze from the top right of the screen to the bottom left all week, but the serving from Ross, the blocking from Kleinman doing damage here. Change of ends. The USA, well, they hold the advantage here. Kleinman going low and late. A really good press into the line, doubling up the USA. Just because Kleinman had the read on Kolomina. So the late move into that zone made it look like a double up. Now Ross serving downwind, choosing to float serve. And she misses. So now Russia at the good end, although the wind is a lot lighter than earlier on in the day. There's still enough there to make April Ross spin from one end and float from the other. Maklogazova from Krasnodar now serving into the breeze. Ross, the target, takes a back set because all of her momentum is going that way. Dig from Kolomina, chance to transition. And that's a wonderful bit of work from Russia. Great balance in the sand. Fantastic little wrist away high line. Well, this Russian team won the under-22s in 2017 in Baden. Beat Romania in the final. Kleinman, high again. She's going to go over the block on copious occasions just because she has that height advantage. It's a two ball down the side of the block this time. Great two ball from the USA. Kolomina. Knuckled to the baby line. And Russia are starting to squeeze their way back into this semi-final. It's a fast-paced start from the USA, but the good end is being utilized well. From the inside, Kolomina holding her ground. April Ross holding her ground as well. This one is a very good game, and unfortunately the set's just a little bit tight from Alex Kleinman. So knuckle comes out for Ross, but to no avail. Two bits of epic defense. It's Hollywood knuckle really from Ross. Trying to twist the ball back on the cut shot. Not far away from the technical timeout here. Russia with the ace. We go to 10-10. Makloga's over. Fired up. The good end. Providing assistance for Russia. It's been a fantastic end for them. They've really taken control. We go to the technical timeout. It's Russia by one. The young Russians, well, they're pushing the Americans here for a place in the final to meet Agatha and Duda. The Dutch program, look closely, the Van Drills on the left in the back of the picture. Tajikistan in the middle. April Ross back in the zone, passes on an angle, chips it back the line. These ends are going to be exciting enough. 7 points per end. Teams will try and win them by as many as possible, but when you're on the right-hand side of this main screen, you have to hold on a little bit. Ross decides to play that one. Kleinman pops it back into the middle. Chance for Russia. They run the back set from way off the net. It's a gutsy, gutsy call from Makloga-Zova, but it pays off for it. Well, fortune does favour the brave at times, doesn't it? Kleinman decides to break, and that proves to give an opening for Makloga-Zova to absolutely shudder that one towards Kleinman. Russia back in the lead, serving with the wind behind. Makloga-Zova on Ross. Big swing from April Ross. Good setting from Kleinman as well, because they're keeping it low due to the wind. It also speeds up the play offensively, which makes it more difficult in so many ways for Russia. Off the net. Kleinman back in the game. The cover is good from Makloga-Zova, but wasted from Holomina. Well, just when one team takes control, the other one comes back. USA from the good end, serving straight down the line. Holomina to the inside. She takes the back set. It's going to blow across her. So she has to be quick, and she goes to the line. April Ross, I think, makes the read there, but too accurate, too deep for April Ross. Gold medal match tomorrow. And this time, a passing error, really, from Kleinman. It shoots off her arms too close to the net for April Ross to keep control. Lead keeps changing. Kleiman. Another fast pass. Advantage rusher, surely. Because there's a change of ends. Lisa Shun watches on. Wow. The favourites for this one on paper would be Ross Kleiman, but for anyone who's been following this game for a while, they know that the Russians are up and coming and they're gaining consistency week after week, and with the way they serve, let's just say it's not ideal for any team who stands in the way. Ross serving one down. Into the wind. Holomina takes a back set. Hats off of Alex Kleiman. Big hefty swing, wasn't it? Whoa. Kleiman keeps full composure. Makro goes over. Spin serve. Way out the back, and that could hurt Russia. Well, it's one of two things, really. Could hurt Russia if they fail to keep up their standards in their own side out. But they have to serve high risk for high reward in this game, especially into the breeze. Have to hit your jumper. Hit it, and hit it well. Perfect passing. Kolomina is so solid there. Keeps everything still. And just to pop the ball in. And the side out levels are good for Russia. Even though they've missed a couple of serves, they still keep the 2-point lead because they can't be stopped by the USA. Ross. Makro goes over. What a recovery that is. And there's actually a little bit of a message from Russia all the same, because Ross has played that really nicely, but the fighting spirit from Russia will certainly send a message the USA's way. Tight setting, jumbo off the knuckle. Makro goes over. Russia are showing no signs of letting up here, no signs of nerves either. They've never beaten the A team. This would be a big moment for them if they could pull through here this evening. Makro is over. Missed a couple from the good end. That's a much better serve, but there's a foot fault from the Russian blocker. Foot must have touched the line or gone over it. The side switch comes with Russia two in charge. Russia have played 34 tournaments together. Makro goes over Holomina. 8 podiums for them. Kleiman Ross, they can't afford the service error there at this time. Such a close game with the teams changing ends at 7. USA at the good end, so they should side out. And April Ross, that's one of the best bits of offense we've seen all day long. She's steaming in towards the seam and just turns it late. Big moments. April Ross spin serve into the wind at 18 serving 19. That's exactly why it's a big moment, because April Ross, time after time in these situations, has heated up. Great timeout from Russia. They've called it at the perfect time to try and burst the bubble. Pardon the pun here in Cancun this week. that burst the bubble of April Ross. It's a big moment now. This next 5 minutes or so. Well, less than that, the next minute or so, the next serve for April Ross is going to tell us a lot about this opening set. Will April Ross serve the USA through here? Will Russia side out? That's the question. Huge moment in the context of this game right here. And April Ross sends an absolute rip over to Russian territory. But the knuckle cutty is a little bit short of the mark. It was a fantastic serve, wasn't it? And again, it just shows how mentally strong April Ross is and experienced in this game. To come out of the timeout and still get after that serve was different level. First set point for Russia. Now there's the Makhlogozova goes after Ross. Back set from Kleiman is very tight. Russian blockers all over it, but Kleiman does well with the cover. They had to bide their time there, the USA. Wow. What a game this one is. The young Russians still have a slight advantage, but Alex Kleiman has a chance for a break here. Gonna serve straight down the line, you'd think, and chasing. Got him into the target. They're moving Kleiman, but they're ready for it. Kleiman to change the momentum here, but no, not this time. Good volleyball all round, though. You can see what the blocking team are doing and the side-out team. Russia trying to make Kleiman move on the net and then chip her around, but set point number two for Russia. Svetlana Kolomina with the ace. Russia take the opening set of this semi-final. What a performance from them as well. Well, they're looking for their second ever four-star win here. Kleiman getting caught quick to the right-hand side. The ball gets past her. Look at the celebrations, but there's still a lot of work to do for them. Russia take the opener here. They've never beaten the Americans. But it's the start they would have wanted. Let's hope the second set follows suit, shall we? Because so far, this has been an intriguing tale between two very good sides. Russia off to a good start once again. Kleiman Good setting from Ross. Just sits that one up in the hitting window. Well, the finals have already been decided in the men's competition. Who will join Agatha and Duda in the women's? This second semi-final, a lot closer than the opener. In the men's finals, Beach Volley Vikings up against Qatar for the second time in a row. That's only happened 14 times in the men's competition. Last time was July 2020. The Hague and Long Beach between. We'll come to that in just a moment because there's an ace. Maklo Gazova has just hammered another big serve to April Ross. It's the same service form that just knocked the Germans aside earlier on. Borgesuda just brushed away, and that's the same Borgesuda that brushed away the world champions the night before, or yesterday evening, sorry. Ross does make a side out this time, though. Russia out of system. The recovery setting isn't too bad at all. Right here says April Ross. Colomina is sat in the pocket. The bump cutty is just left lacking slightly. Russia have got opportunities though. The defense from Colomina. Look how solid she is until the last possible moment of contact. And she has to drop to her knees. But April Ross talking to Nina Hobe. So last time there were back-to-back finals, so Hague and Long Beach between Marish Prudel, Shegos Fijilek. Fiji's still going, strong on this world tour. And Phil Dalhauser and Sean Rosenthal. Phil Dalhauser's still going strong on this tour. Side switch, 4-3. I'd say it's the calm before the storm, but it's been stormy here for a short while, isn't it? Kleiman serving straight down the line, but that one's got too much heat on it. Lamina, who's been in inspired form this evening. Ace on April Ross. That's twice in this set that the serve has beaten April Ross. Flat. Deflection off the net ban certainly didn't help the equation for her, did it? Russia have taken the lead at the so-called bad end. Ross put to the floor again, so she's out of rhythm. Colomina sees it. Maklo Gazova uses her head there. She really does. Has a quick look. And with the knuckle, turns it towards the sideline. Service pressure from Russia once more, having a knock-on effect to the Americans. Better, they're in rhythm, but Ross with the error. And this is starting to become difficult for them already because, well, Svetlana Kolomina serving really tough and causing issues for the Americans. Another big, powerful float serve. Ross does get the ball in. The lefty hammer from the left side. Maybe just catches Colomina a little bit out of sorts because she's expecting it to come from the right side. The left hand poses a different threat and you have to adapt to it. And that's why playing with your left hand, all jokes aside, is really effective because they're not lined up to play from that side. The defensive lines change depending on what hand you attack with. Akers looks on in the background. Better from April Ross, doing a bit of pushing back here. Both teams going full tilt with their serves here in Cancun. That ace may have just calmed the USA down, and if the first ace didn't, well, then maybe that one from April Ross did. Another change of ends, and they've saved themselves there, the USA, because, well, they were three down at the good end, and they've just saved themselves. Aggression from April Ross to be admired, but now the wind behind her, she's going to choose to jump float, and she does rip that serve well. The passing work, they run Kleinman around. That's really smart, looking like she's going to take on the back set, Colomina. Kleinman goes with her, then goes back the other way to the front set, and that's catching the USA out. Kluger's over. Some big serves coming out tonight, isn't there? Big angle from Kleinman. Little bit of luck from the net band that time, but they need it, the USA. They don't know when to give in. The Americans. Two balls coming. Matt Kloger-Zova picks that perfectly. Pounces on that two ball. They're a very, very organized and world-class outfit, aren't they, Russia? Just out. Well tracked from April Ross. She takes the responsibility with her. Change of service from April Ross, choosing to spin serve downwind. To no avail. We're two away from the technical timeout. Russia will want to go to the technical timeout as many up as possible because they have the headwind at the moment. But not with April Ross starting to come back to full form. Crisp high line. Some of these serves. Very, very heated. USA that go in to the technical timeout, 1 point in the lead. That's a great end for them to win that end with the wind behind them. That sends a message to Russia, that's for sure, but who knows what happens here.
Invisible.
technical timeout here in Cancun has come at the perfect time for Russia. They just hit a little bit of a brick wall when their service reception for the first time in this matchup. Change of ends means a change of tactics, adapting all the time. Kleiman serving. USA 1-0 down. April Ross off the net from the left side. It's a fantastic break. The Makro goes over, and it's a really good transition play too. Makro goes over, knows that the soft swing is away from the body there, so she breaks into it because she has more time to back off. Then she just delivers a great cut shot herself. Russia serving downwind with some potency. April Ross aced again. It's because it's a great serve. Russia now take the lead. It's up and down like a yo-yo. Makro goes over now, blocking the wrist away. Monster block for a reason. The crowd outside the bubble love it. Kolomina, two to the good. Since the technical timeout, it's a 3-point swing for Russia. This could be a 4-point swing. What a run this is. Kolomina off the hands. Another opportunity. They're running wide to the pin to move the blocker. Fantastic run. Kleinman knew what was coming. And that's what this game is about. Teams will know exactly what the other team are trying to do to them, but can you stop it? Not if they do what they want to do well. That's what Russia did there. Run the ball 6 or 7 meters. Just try and go off the block. Finally a point for the A team. They stay alive. 4-point swing was a very good one, though, for Russia. They're looking good, aren't they? Ross into the breeze, jump serve, needs to get this one in. It is in, but Kolomina's passing is once again into the right spot to then move the ball around. The wind is coming off the ocean, so to run the back set keeps it in the hitting window. But Russia, miraculous today. Solid, consistent. This end, post-technical, has really put them in the driving seat towards a 2-0 victory here. Kleinman off the net. Kleinman off the hands. Side switch has come. That's a huge point, again, in the context of this set, because it's a 2-point game, which could have easily been a 4-point game, which have been a horror show for the USA, but they hang on in there. Kleinman this time, serving, wind behind. And I think it's these situations where Russia have been on top. The passing, both teams serving well. But finally there's a break for the USA. Just feel at times that Russia have passed a bit better off the tough float serves than the US. But elegant break from Kleinman. Fantastic transition, it really is. A lot of work there having to break Kleinman, but if she feels like her block's not going to do any good, she has to get off. Oh, same as the first point of this game. Everything's inside and April Ross turns it back outside. Phenomenal. Kleinman serving. Two ball. Knuckle from Matt Kroger's over, keeps the lead, rushes away, and now they have the serve, which is a key component in the second set for them. Kleiman Ross starting to play really well as well. Not really been anything between these two teams from start to finish. Matt Kroger's over though, gets one on April Ross. Lines up nicely, takes the line away. The 2-point lead has opened up once again. Still another three to the change. Ross, this time to the line, diving into the angle. Matt Kloger's over. USA will not let Russia get away. They're going to make them fight for everything. April Ross serving downwind, choosing to go back to the float serve to keep consistency. Perfect passing and setting from Russia, chopping it back on the cut shot. And as we were saying before, big points come around in this sport, and this is another big one because, well, the change of ends at 35 is coming. Is it going to be a 1-point game? Or is it going to be a 3-point game? USA have clawed it back a bit. April Ross to side out. No, Matt Kloger's over. Seals another line block on one of the greatest players of all time. USA, well, they have to take a breath and a rest. They go for a timeout. And that's just because the ball's drifting across April Ross. She only has the line available.
We will start at noon. Mañana las 12. Empezamos las 12, sí? Yeah. Bronze medal match. Women, men. Right after that, the gold medals match.
The Russian squad. Looking on closely, this would be a huge victory for Maklogazova and Kolomina. They won the Espino 4-star, they've been there before, but haven't consistently made finals. And they have everything it takes, don't they? Service pressure. Great structure. Both players run a great offensive system. But this now is almost Russia's to lose. April Ross, perfect passing. Two ball from Kleiman. They just changed that up and it's the perfect offense to run at this time. April Ross works her feet nicely to get across that ball. USA have the good end. That was a big side out for them. Off the net slightly from Kolomina, but into a good place. The cut shot is calm. They have to keep their nerve here. 23-year-old Kolomina will serve. Ball's always going cross court due to the ball dropping inside. But match point for Russia. A little bit of an upset here if they can take this one. Kleiman keeps the game alive for the USA.
Come on. Miracle action. April Ross.
One saves. And we know what's coming now. It's an April Ross jump serve into the wind. She needs two. What a moment for the USA. First one's good, but in system, Russia to qualify for another final. They've done it in straight sets. What a performance here in Cancun this evening. Svetlana Kolomina, Nadezhda Maklogazova from Russia. The sixth seeds have upset Alex Kleiman and April Ross from the USA. A quite brilliant performance from the service line. They've passed very well as well.